Magnus Carlsen, widely regarded as the greatest of all time, has left an indelible mark on chess history. Today, we will explore his most brilliant moves ever played. Surely these will blow your mind. Let's dive right in. In our first game, Magnus Carlsen plays as white against Param Maksudlu, an Iranian grandmaster, in the final round of the World Rapid Chess Championship 2022. Carlsen opens with pawn to e4, while Param responds with the Sicilian defense. As the game progresses, it transitions into the classical Sicilian, with Param opting for knight to c6, and Magnus going for the sharper Richter-Rauser variation by moving his bishop to g5. Subsequent moves witness Magnus executing long castling, while Black chooses to keep his king in the center and launch an attack on Magnus' king's side by advancing his pawns b5, a5, and b4. Magnus counters with an attack of his own by pushing his pawns h4 and g4. The game continues with Magnus striving to mount an assault on the king's side, while Param activates his queen and rook to launch a counterattack on Magnus' king. After Magnus moves his rook to h2, supporting the c2 pawn, Param adopts an aggressive approach by playing pawn to d5 and executing short castling, allowing Magnus' pawn on e5 to capture their knight on f6. If Magnus captures the knight, Black may recapture the pawn with their bishop, followed by the queen capturing the knight on g3 and attacking the rook on h2. Magnus decides not to capture the knight, and through strategic maneuvering of his pieces, proceeds with the lethal attack of h5 and g5 in the subsequent moves. In an attempt to reduce the tension, Param tries to trade as many minor pieces as possible, and offers a trade at b5 with his bishop. It is at this point that Magnus sacrifices his bishop by playing bishop to h7. After the king recaptures the bishop, Magnus delivers a check by moving his pawn to g6. Following the capture of the pawn by Black, Magnus executes the clever move queen to f7, threatening checkmate with the h5 pawn, capturing the g6 pawn. Black responds with g5, and Magnus proceeds with h6, trying to open the h-file by capturing the g7 pawn with his h-pawn in the next move. With no chance of a comeback, Param resigns the game. In the next game, Magnus Carlsen faces Ian Nipponishi in the Tata Steel Chess Championship. Magnus begins with pawn to e4, while Ian opts for the Sicilian defense. In the third move, Magnus chooses bishop to b5, selecting a side variation instead of the main d4 variation. In the subsequent moves, both players develop their pieces and complete their castling. After castling, Magnus gains an advantage with his active minor pieces, while Ian's pieces remain passive. Magnus trades his knight for Ian's bishop on b7 and solidifies his strength in the center of the board by placing his knight on d5. Bringing his rooks into the game, Magnus takes advantage of his double bishop and the long bishop diagonal to pose significant threats to Ian. Magnus first makes Ian's queen passive by positioning his bishop on c4 and queen on b3, attacking the f7 pawn. He gradually creates a passed pawn for himself on the b-file. Ian sacrifices a pawn on d4 by playing his knight to d4 to trade one of the bishops and gain some active play. Magnus happily captures the pawn, increasing his chances of activating all his pieces. The only hope for Black is to trade major pieces and aim for a draw with opposite colored bishops. However, Magnus Carlsen has other plans. Utilizing the advanced pawn on b7, Magnus steadily improves his position by playing pawn to g3 and f4. He swiftly moves his queen from the queen side to the king side and plays pawn to e5, threatening bishop to e4 and potentially leading to queen to h7 checkmate. Recognizing the impending danger, Black resigns the game. In this match, Magnus clearly demonstrates his exceptional skills in activating his pieces to defeat Ian. In the next match, Magnus Carlsen plays Black against Anish Giri in the World Blitz Chess Championship. Anish opens with pawn to e4, and Magnus responds with pawn to e6, opting for the French defense. The game quickly transitions into the Winawer variation of the French defense. Both players play the normal opening moves, and Anish tries to break into the king's side with his queen to g4, pawn to h4, h5, and f4 in the next few moves. Magnus also responds with pawn to f5 and g4, leaving the king's side closed. Anish takes the c5 pawn, resulting in a tripled pawn on c-file. Magnus chooses to trade the c5 pawn by playing his pawn to b6 to activate his c8 bishop. White has an extra pawn, but lacks piece development. Anish should plan to play his knight d4, then develop his f1 bishop and finally his h1 rook. After playing bishop to d2 and knight to d4, Anish seems to have a decent position with an extra pawn. Now, Magnus plays queen to c5, which turns out to be a blunder, as now Anish can trade the queens and activate his pieces with a c4 bishop. After the pieces are traded, Anish has a double bishop advantage with an extra pawn. Normally, this would be enough for a player of Anish Giri's caliber to beat Magnus Carlsen. Let's see if Magnus Carlsen can use his in-game skills in this game to make a comeback. After bringing his rook to b1, Anish had a good opportunity to play pawn to c4 to have good control over the center. However, Anish misses that move and plays bishop to e2, giving Magnus a chance to push his pawn to c4. Now, the bishop on e2 is completely trapped by the black pawns on c4 and g4. Magnus Carlsen brings his positional skills into the game, and slowly brings his king into play. Magnus Carlsen is virtually having a piece extra, as Anish's bishop on e2 has no chance of getting into the game. After a few more moves, the rooks get traded, and Anish picks the h6 pawn and plans to promote the h-pawn. However, Carlsen brings his king to manage the h-pawn. The only way for Anish to play some active chess is to bring his king forward and sacrifice the bishop for the g4 pawn, pushing his pawn to f5. However, Anish Giri couldn't find this move under time pressure. In the meantime, Magnus circles around his knight to attack the c3 pawn. With mounting pressure, Anish Giri lost on time. Magnus Carlsen, from an unsatisfactory position, turned this game around with his exceptional risk-free positional chess. Despite being a pawn down, Magnus skillfully maneuvered his pieces and exploited the trapped bishop on e2, ultimately securing a victory. In the next game, Magnus Carlsen plays black against Anish Giri in the Meltwater Champions Chess Tour. Anish opens with e4, and Magnus responds with Sicilian defense. After a few normal development moves, Magnus takes the d4 knight. Anish can't capture the knight back as he would lose his bishop on b5, so Anish plays pawn to a4, supporting his bishop and planning to take the black knight on the next move. In this position, Magnus does the unimaginable. He goes for a queen sacrifice variation by capturing the b5 bishop with his knight, allowing the e3 bishop to capture the queen on b6. In this sacrifice, Magnus gets three minor pieces for his queen. It is a completely unreal move, sacrificing a queen for three pieces within the first 10 moves, and the position looks very unclear as well, leaving both players in unfamiliar territory. In the next few moves, Magnus carefully places his pieces in the right spots to activate them. Anish also gains some space advantage by pushing his pawns to the fourth rank. After a few more moves, Anish Giri sacrifices a couple of pawns on b4 and d7 to activate his queen. Even though Magnus' king is in the center of the board, Anish couldn't breach it thanks to Magnus' three solid minor pieces. After a few more moves, one rook gets traded, and Magnus Carlsen solidifies his position by having his knight connected on g6 and e7, and his bishop on e6 also safeguards Magnus' king from any potential danger. In this scenario, Magnus slowly maneuvers his pieces and trades his doubled pawn on the b-file for the c4 pawn. With a completely safe king, Magnus starts picking off Anish's pawns one by one, and gradually turns the game in his favor. He finally wins the game after advancing his f-pawn toward promotion. Throughout the game, Anish couldn't launch any successful attack on Magnus' daring king on f7. This is a classical example of how Magnus Carlsen can capitalize on unclear positions and exploit his opponents with his exceptional skills in positional chess. Magnus is truly one of a kind. His ability to adapt to different positions and exploit his opponent's weaknesses sets him apart as a true chess genius.